Доброе утро, уважаемые друзья. Я предлагаю всем, кто хочет начать работу в рамках...
Good morning, dear ladies and gentlemen. Please take your seats. We are going to start our work in our digital room. My name is Igor Bogachev. I'm IT Lasta Skolkova head, and I'd like to welcome you all here and try to pay your attention to the agenda of our room, what we're going to do today. Please pay your attention. We have a very wide agenda in terms of pitch sessions. We have six pitch sessions, which are going to be ended at 6 p.m. Informational security, digital technologies for retail, robots and communications, Internet of Things, entertainment and all related things. And the last one is B2B, related to digital modeling. Dear the colleagues which take part in the pitch sessions, please take pay attention to these photographs. These are colleagues of IT clusters, the moderators of the sessions. Please, you can meet them and understand how to take part in this session in a most high-quality way. If you brought a new version of your presentation, please provide these presentations to our specialists. I'd like to switch the slide. Please note that besides the official program, we have a couple of nominations from our partners who are in this room today. This is Sberbank, Cisco, Intel, which will also determine their own nominations. They will select the companies they like and will announce from 7 to 8 p.m. the winner of each nomination on the main stage. And in parallel, today we're launching the competition on IT security, information security, with help of our partners Cisco, InfoWatch, Symantec, Boles, and Sergei Khodakov, who is going to moderate the first session, the main operator of this competition. So please use the opportunity to talk to him. And tomorrow there are going to be a very interesting agenda. Those who are going to visit us tomorrow can take part in roundtables, can listen to the presentation of IBM. We will have a roundtable on digital retail, a roundtable on startups dealing with portable devices, with added virtuality. IP will talk about digital enterprise and the technologies which are most asked for, and the continuation of our competition, which is going to be started now, the IT security program. I'd like to finish my welcoming word, and I'd like to give the floor to Sergei, who is going to directly moderate the first pitch session devoted to the information security. Thank you. Thank you very much for your welcoming word. I'd like to ask to display the next presentation. It's the wrong one. It's the presentation from tomorrow, the roundtable, which is supposed to happen tomorrow at 3:30 p.m., 45 minutes. And now I'd like to go directly to pitch sessions of today. Today we will have 12 projects selected by our experts. And I'd like to invite the first project, Altel VDI product, personal data protection and corporate data protection for mobile devices. Please. Well, you will have 4 minutes for presentation and 3 minutes for questions and answers from the jury. Good morning, dear friends. My name is Franz Vikenti. I'm director of Altel company. We develop Altel VDI for corporate market. We are solving the problem of personal and corporate data protection stored on mobile devices. We do it in the most user-friendly way, due to the fact that despite our competitors, our security features are integrated in the devices, and these means segregate personal corporate data by physical means. The use of portable devices is becoming a norm, and normally both personal and corporate data are stored on portable devices, and employees use them outside of their offices. So the protection means normally are inconvenient, some applications are blocked and services are blocked by them. By the way, these means of protection does not allow to avert risk of fraud or compromising. The modern trend of the technology and development of use of portable devices is dictated by the following considerations. Normally, employees can bring in to the offices their portable devices, and it creates additional problems for data protection. The market is growing, and by 2017, it is going to reach around 300 million devices annually. Currently, we have solutions of protections referring to mobile device management and infrastructure, virtual desktops. As against our competitors, our protection feature is focused not only to the protection of corporate data access, but also can protect personal data. Our protection means are directly integrated in the device, so it is not possible to circumvent them in case of fraud or in case of loss of the device. How do we plan to build up sales? We have two strategies of going to the market. First is in our in-house brand, and for that we have an agreement with Pegatron. And the second area is licensing by leading OEM vendors. Our team is as the ex-employees of AMD company who were managing business development and development of software, and also Altel company employees. The current project status is the following. We've passed quite a big journey, and currently we have developed a prototype and signed agreement with leading manufacturers of the hardware. Sales strategy is the following. We have to sign an agreement with one major Russian vendor, and in case of successful project development, go to the international market. Investments, $3 million, we are ready to provide the share of the company. Thank you very much. 4 minutes are over. Thank you very much for your interesting presentation. Please, dear jury, you can ask questions. Thank you very much, but we didn't quite get you. What's the point of your product? The point of the product is integration of protection means inside the BS. So you are going to take the device and to integrate. Yes, the device will be provided with embedded protection, X-Works. Next question, please. If we speak about VDI, I understood that you use some encrypted channel from client to the server, right? Yes, you're right. And this both server part and client part is developed by us. So it is linked to your server part. And if I understood you correctly, our universal client allows to work both with VDI solutions of Microsoft, Citrix, and others. And so the question is, what are the encryption algorithms, Russian and Western, OAS and GOST? Thank you. Good morning. I have two questions. First, did anyone analyze to what extent your protection device is in line with global standards, or such analysis is needed? Yes, we use NIST recommendations for protection features. So I don't speak about recommendations. Concrete your solution. Did anyone analyze it? Currently, we working along the Russian legislation. So only Russian experts did this analysis. Could you cite? It's FSB and STEC. These are regulators, market regulators. So you have the regulation of the security service. Yes, and STEC and FSB, right. If I understood you correctly, you used the word MDM, mobile device management. How do you compete here with the mature market? Yes, we do compete, but MDM are not convenient normally. Is it your personal opinion? Not my personal opinion. This is the opinion of Gartner and IDC. Again, MDM doesn't protect from all threats. Could you cite an example what neither of the existing MDA does, but your product does? This is personal data encryption and access ban to the personal data on the mobile device when the person works in the corporate environment. Thank you very much for your interesting presentation and for your answers. And I'd like to invite to the next team, IB Group, Brandpoint Protection, the system of protection of intellectual data. Your presentation, please. Good morning, dear colleagues, GIB Group, Ruslan Kriulin. Within Skolkovo, we develop CyberCop. And there are four main blocks: threat center, monitoring system, botnet with the feature of DDoS attack detection, this cybercrime monitor, which is the system of analysis and correlation of data, and system fraud monitor, which is the system to exchange data inside the banking society by the results of detected fraud and DBO system compromisation. And Brandpoint Protection, this is SAS solution to protect intellectual rights in the internet. And one of the side block of this system is anti-piracy block. I'd like to start from the following. In the modern world, there are several threats for brands, which our solutions allow to cover. These are phishing sites and sites using names of major companies. This is digital piracy, music, video, software, books, and so on. These are sales of counterfeited products in the internet, black PR, and confidential information dissemination. More about our solution. The service Brandpoint Protection, as I already told you, is a SaaS solution to protect copyright. First, the anti-piracy block and intellectual property protection, within which we can track down all dissemination facts, torrent trackers, social networks, and other portals where you can have a video or use other resources where you can download similar products. The system detects all facts of dissemination in an automatic mode, can block these broadcasting, close torrent trackers, delete some counterfeited data sets, protection of reputation, business reputation. We detect all facts of confidential information dissemination, and we can detect, delete this information or monitor it. The monitoring of counterfeited products, here we speak about physical counterfeited products, some clothes, mineral mineral resources, some luxury items, and we can detect all these sources, and in an online mode we can close them. Increasing in this way the official distribution channel, and monitoring of mobile markets, monitoring of App Store, Android market, in order to detect and find and detect fraudulent applications and their closure. According to the evaluations of Western analyzing companies, research companies, by 2012, the market of protection products was $2.2 billion. The volume by 2018 will be $3.8 billion. The right holders' loss from internet piracy is now around $1 billion. So the problem exists, and we have to cope with it somehow. Now I'd like to move to the required investments. To develop the project, we need the 7 billion rubles, and in 2015 the expected turnover is as follows. And what are our plans to spend money? Is increasing the number of and the capacity of servers. Next plans, development and implementation of content ID technology in order to improve the quality and to increase the volumes of content search, and the creation of a user-friendly interface, and different PR activities in order to go to international market. Ruslan, thank you very much. Your time is up. Dear jury, please, your questions to Ruslan. I didn't quite get the idea about deleting information from servers which violate copyright. For instance, somebody placed a film on YouTube. How technically can you delete it? Technically, this function was realized. We have an agreement with YouTube. We have so-called admin panel in order to In case of detection of a film, using different metrics, using FinGen printing technology, we can delete the film within 1.5 hours. So of course, if we have all documents conforming our rights, our authorities. So it means that there should be additional agreements with content providers. Yes, certainly. The social network VKontakte is our partners, is now partner in this way, and this is also agreement with big right holders, publishing houses, movie companies. On the business model, I didn't quite get how are you going to earn money. We plan to earn money by providing non-inclusive license to use the system. The right holder can get a login and password and can track down and independently manage these settings on detection or removal of the content. Next question, please. The competitive advantages, how do you see them? If they are only in the fact that you have agreements with all main hosting providers and you just remove it, basically a similar company can pop up which would have the same service and the same agreements. What is your advantage? The advantage of our company is that despite that apart these agreements with providers, we, our core company and is engaged in investigation of cybercrime. We can cover the whole cycle of cybercrime. We can find and close the content if it's interesting. We can find the pirate, the person, and make this person responsible.
You mentioned at one point that you delete the confidential information from the site. How you accomplish that? When you do that, there's certain base of sites where such confidential information is posted, and we have information regarding the owners of those resources. We send such type of letter, like we send to some site, torrent site, and through negotiations, through agreements, we delete this or that information, be it photograph, text, log. So as we know, the information goes in waves, and what do you do after that? True. Well, speaking about with the reputation risks, first and foremost that we should do, once we detected something negative, we should stop it. Oftentimes, information can go through social networks. Within a day or two, we can stop it, then it will not go on further. So we have to stick to the timetable. Thank you very much for your questions, for your answers. And now I give the floor to the next project, the Iran project. This is a project of the general, the cloud surveillance. iVideo, the topic of my presentation. We do video surveillance via internet. You want to see what happens to your child in the next room or what happens to your house when you're away. You install a camera at your workplace. The camera sends a picture to our cloud, and you can see this in from any point. So it's the cloud sends you some notification if someone approaches the camera or electricity went off. This is cool. So we also use this service by businesses who would like to supervise how well their workers doing, or they want to. The business model is very simple. We provide services to the end user. We're very good at that. In last year, we earned in excess of $1 million in one. We have 5 million users all over the world. What we decided to go further, we decided that we can take, present us a platform to other companies so that they can, based on our platform, provide services to their clients. So whereby we put together our marketing efforts, our channel of distributions, our user databases, and we can reach to a large number of subscribers across the world. So who are these companies with whom we, who are the user of our platform? First of all, telecom operators, Telefonica, Vodafone, Deutsche Telefon, T-Mobile, all major operators who are honestly looking how they should increase the average check of their subscriber, how they could create new value-added services. They are our clients. The second group, OEM manufacturers, Philips, Samsung, that's major companies that have global distribution networks across the world, who want their cameras, their equipment, become smart cameras so that the user can use it very easily. And third, manufacturers, factories, who would like to get from the cloud some revenue, that is kind of revenue sharing. What we I described, this works already. Now let me show a couple of examples. Philips. Philips cameras today served through our service. You can go a Samsung camera in Eastern Europe, in other, so it's sold with our service. SoftBank, the second operator in Japan, it already in our services, so whereby we work in this provides benefits to us, to our with the help of these three projects, we grew 10 times faster than without them. We know that we can be very successful. Just going along that path, we calculated the market situation. We for the next 12 months, the 76 should be different figure there. $6 billion should be our market. We prepared to capture 2% of that market. Presently, we are looking for technological partners so that we jointly could joint efforts to capture the market. In that, we should just invest more money in order to earn more. We need $5 million. In order to for 25% share of stock of our company, we spent this money to open new offices, to expand the database centers, to expansion on the Asian market and marketing efforts. Thank you very much. Now, members of panel, please go ahead with your questions. Well, could you tell us whether you are profit-making in the last 12 months? As I mentioned, we earned in excess of $1 million on cloud. Cloud is a kind of service. I cannot just spell all the beans, but it's very profitable. It gives a lot of money. You didn't say anything about the competitors. Well, we have competitors. We provide the service Dropcam in United States, for instance. One of the competitors, the company that earns a loan that sells the same kind of cameras here, it will be hard to compete had we not to go to the platform. In this model of platforms, we don't have competitors. There's no big platforms with data centers across the world, with call centers in three languages, with large number of users, non-market that would provide such services. Here, we kind of unique. No competitors, just follow up on this question of competition. We work on three markets, United States, Europe, Asia. How the requirements of customers differ, what competitors' edge we use on each market to go there. So it's a lot of things need to be done. So had we start to try to learn how to sell to Chinese our services, we know situation very well in Russia. So we go to our partners who have the experience. SoftBank, for instance, they are the largest operator in Japan. Our other partners, they also know very well their local users. We give them platform, and based on that platform, probably with their own label, they organize their pricing policy because they know their client best, and we provide only our technological platform. So in 3 to 6 weeks, they should get off the ground. Well, are we talking that you can get access to some private things? Can you say a couple of words about how the security and privacy is assured? Personally, on my level, I know how we know the protocols of data transfer is called, how in the cloud we distributed storage information. I understand. So if someone gets access to our cloud, he cannot just put together all these pieces. As a staff member, I cannot get access to all cameras as to mine. But I understand that all answers could not be satisfactory to your technical specialist, as I would like to just to get you acquainted with our security chief, with our specialists, so that you can just in great detail dig into this problem. So with that, thank you very much for your presentation. Now I'd like to invite to this podium the next project, Monson Inc. project. It's called Voluan project. Please. Well, my name is Stepan. A few words about the Voluan product. this is for the protection of the attacks. So what problems we're trying to address? From 2009, we do audits of large projects. We have a lot of big customers, banks. After our customers thanks us, we found a lot of weak spots, but we'll just rectify them. But some people say so we try to come up with a solution that will just assure security as a process. Try to install the firewall. From 2009 we started to work on not our solution, which is like an alarm product now materialized. Well, it's old presentation, by the way. But how we stack up against others from the very beginning? We were aiming at the high productivity projects. We have different regimes of deployments, synchronized, asynchronized. We understood that just to block attacks is not enough. We have to show the specific problems in the application. Look for how. So it's not the application. We can tell how to rectify the situation. Big problem of for most solution they use signatures. They do not cover all types of attacks. We decided to depart from this method. We using the teaching machines, so we built correlations. We have a lot of statistics in order just to fine-tune our solution, and then in order to detect attacks based on search for anomalies and like just reduce the number of false alarms. So in general, there's alarm mode, which is installed in the infrastructure of the company. This thing is based off Nginx wall server that is used in 35% of the most loaded sites of the world. There's come queries, it filters based on certain rules. This filtered goes on this application. So the writes are formed in clouds, all this instant warrants. They produce this information on the traffic. We understand what they are encrypting and build that model and the rules for the blocking. So on what market we prepare just gearing to work for it's. $437 million. There's a large. There's a large players on that market. We are selling through various fashions. We can sell these Volare modes when we sell these virtual instances, but use our clouds. These are big companies who don't give away traffic outside their structure. We can use this Volare standalone. In that case, we have create a network, the 100% cloud solution that clients can just get the protection from DDoS attacks and hacker attacks. We now just very actively working in that direction. So as I mentioned, from 2009, we are in information security. We have top clients in internet and financial. So in our team, we have Ivan Novikov, Sergei, who can prove that he is one of the most known analysts in security, security analysts. So, well, we're here just to look for partners, and we are not looking for the investments as per person. Thank you. Members of the panel, now time for your questions. Could you tell us, please, you found, say, some anomaly, you blocked the access, but if it's a vital thing for business and it turned out this is very needed things for the business sustained, what is the feedback? How you can deblock if it's done by mistake? Was this false triggers? So we very successfully assure the minimum times of through this training. But if this fault alarm occurs, so there's certain cutoff wealth. So the but this is a living system by and large. It does not block for infinite time. It sees certain queries that looks normal. It will not block, but it will block for some. My understanding is that in manual regime, the user should call some number or inform somebody. True. Yeah, there are different blocking mechanisms. There's a lot of information. Some clients will include it in monitoring modes when this critically important not to lose any kind of traffic there. But probably, you mentioned machine learning. You should, so all this, this is all of machine learning. Machine learning is for the last 10 years is developing at a fast clip, and actually you are tackling the this goal of. But in your team, do you have some serious mathematicians? Their presence, it will end in nothing. Is serious mathematics? Scores of companies try to tackle this problem. A lot of publication, the subject in your team, do you have some serious mathematicians? On machine learnings, on machine learnings and on classifications and well, there's multidimensional. This is not tackled yet. This is in the world. Well, machine learning is a buzzword. Is well under which we have a lot of things, and we do profiling web application. We see what queries coming. See what parameters are accepted by application, how application behaves. We build partners and looking for deviations. This is a kind of a difficult task. We have, could you give us names of these talented people that you have? I don't think Konstantin Salhov, for instance, he is not known. He is a winner of Olympians in machine learning sector. It's unknown name. So my main point, machine learning is a very important thing. We have a lot of statistics, a lot of training going on, but this is not the core thing. We have expertise, knowledge, how these products works, what problems they have, and we try to protect our users. Well, so thank you very much for your, Stepan, for your very interesting presentation, for your answers to the questions. And now I'd like to give floor to the next project with St. Petersburg State University, IPPN. Good morning. I'm Alice Ace. I'm chief of the project IBPR. This project with Petersburg State University jointly. Well, what is the idea underpinning this project? The team, which, well, I'll describe it later. We, from our experience, 90% of all errors that are internet on the services, they are this or that implementation of codes. They at the end at very encrypted languages, and well, indeed, there's the largest number of mistakes there. 90% of mistakes in the last mile, so to say, of the software, and hence. Oftentimes, is our service secure? Not secure. So, does it have any errors? And to have a look, we need at no vulnerable places. Well, not always very good implemented. Say, well, what? Who is in our team? First of all, the graduates from St. Petersburg and Novosibirsk universities, who after graduation worked in security area, many work in such companies as youngest men, or international projects, including this old Aller Globux. So, what we propose? The package for developers, for the companies who do something to split it into two parts. One part will deal with the that we can scan. They can scan the services for the known vulnerability or for in order to do re-engineering of implementation of this or that protocols. For instance, well, lately we a lot of errors created were. The second part is analyzer of the source code. So many competitors, they just analyze binary codes, but we propose to limit to the languages that are used for web programming. Well, now it's absolutely clear that 90% of errors happen at the end. Indeed, the errors that happened, they are at the end. We do not promise that we 100% tackle this issue, but we eliminate many errors that people do while programming. Who needs that? Well, basically everybody who in this or that way involved in exploitation of services or who works in the development of starting from the government all the way down to the web developers. Well, just if we take a look, for instance, if we take two most vivid last producers of scanners or binary Codenomic, Arconetics, they are mostly concentrate on scanning issues. Codenomic, they follow a path close to ours. They analyze binary codes to detect the vulnerability. We propose to go further, not to analyze binary, but to analyze the code itself, not to compile it, but constrain code. We believe this is the fastest way to find the error in each type. We should not recompile. At the stage of creation of software, we already can detect errors. Regarding this model, we believe that mostly it would be to be and box moving and SaaS model. So, but probably we creating prototypes. We lack proper financing, but we're looking for financing $1.5 million for prototyping and using to this and going to the sales.
Please, dear jury, your questions. I have three questions. First. Your competitors are indicated as black box, and what about Fortify and others who are engaged in the analysis, in the analyzing of the source code? The second, the volume of your team. You have a number of languages, and the work labor intensity of the analysis of source code of source codes. Non-solvable problems, still a big volume of work. And the third question, what's the main method you use while analyzing the source code? Based on your list, it's the big pattern match. We have 12 people in our team and technical personnel. We don't take sales or administrative stuff. If we so to your first question about competitors, in principle maybe we missed it, but first of all we looked at companies which are engaged in the analysis for web, not just analysis as is. And to your last question, the answer will be. The main things which are normally achieved is reduction of the priority level, the name of algorithms, pattern matching, paint analysis. What have you got? Pattern matching. We use pattern matching. I don't know what the previous speaker asked. I don't know the terminology, and where do you get the vulnerabilities? My question is as simple as that. The most precious thing here is the team, which has been working here for 15 years. So what do you analyzing that for? You said for vulnerabilities. Where do you get these vulnerabilities you analyze things for? For instance, ACVA, the global repository on vulnerabilities. Repository, right, that's one thing. some of our developments on in-house development and code. Okay, thanks. If no questions anymore, then thank you very much for your interesting presentation and your answers. And let me introduce our next team, Air Vision, which is engaged in automation of centralized management of information security of organizations. Good morning. My name is Alexander Bondarenko. I'm the CEO of Air Vision. Air Vision is a specialized software toolkit for the management responsible for information security management in the company. And that's one of our main distinctive features, because the security is perceived as an applied discipline to solve some specific problems. But in the recent times, there is more need for management, for efficient management of these activities. And the efficient management requires specialized tools. That's what's our focus. We focus on creating tools which allow to the management to efficiently solve problems. Our client, Alexei, CSIO in a big company, in a big international group. Alexei has to solve lots of management problems, has to stick to the regulations, take part in the cooperation with business, make reporting, risk control, and all these should be done with limited resources and with problems to allocate high quality staff to solve these problems. These are the problems that we faced in our previous consulting activities, and then they made us think about creating a specialized system which would allow to the management and to the team to consolidate all the information, to carry out analytics, and to automate these routine activities as much as possible for the management in order to make him concentrate himself on the solutions and analyzing of information. The product is modular. It has a number of components for different tasks. There are components for risk management, compliance management, incident management. We've been developing now the asset management module. We have in general 7 modules, which in perspective should cover the whole set of tasks of the information security manager of the company. This is a tool which allows a visualization and to download the information to interact with business, to interact with regulators. Market. Currently, the clients of our company are more than 70 organizations in Russia, predominantly banks, because the regulation is developing very rapidly in this area. And now we are going beyond this branch, this area. We have non-banking clients, and we also have the first clients in Belarus and Kazakhstan, and some companies are interested in Azerbaijan, our nearest neighbors with whom we have good relations already. For the nearest future, we plan to develop not only in Russia, not only banking sector, large companies, oil and gas, energy, state-owned companies, and also go to the international market, because the problems that I mentioned, they are pressing for all countries, for Asian regions, for leading economies of Europe, for Northern and Southern America. Our average valuation for sales is $20,000 and plus 30% for technical support annually. This is an average number. Everything would depend on the volume of the company. The team is only 10 people now. This is the main core here on the slide. This is symbiosis between the consultant and experts, which have long-term experience in consulting, and they understand very well what client needs and what are the solutions to solve. And on the other hand, the developers of the program code, which allows to the client to solve his or her problems. We look for investments. We estimate them at 30 million rubles. We plan to use them to develop our developments, to improve our developments, and to go to new markets. Now clients are ready to purchase the product with additional functions which are not integrated in the product, and the growth of our clients depend on the intensity of our development. I'm ready to answer to your questions. If I understood you correctly, This is a simple, empty basis which should be populated with different indicators, risk management, risk assessment, and then afterwards it would proceed something in a beautiful form. No, absolutely not. How can it assess risks? You said that this empty base. It's not an empty base. Upload there all necessary analytics. The system needs just to give to the system the input data, the inputs. So wouldn't be more complicated to give inputs than to evaluate risks on the existing methods. You said $26,000 per year interest. I wonder what kind of banks can pay this money from top 100, but they don't need it. They have a powerful team. Other banks just don't have this money and current my information. Thank you for your questions. It was $20,000, but plus annual support. First question, whether it's simple. No, it's not simpler because clients come with these problems. They don't want to do it manually. They need a system. And our development is focused on the automation to reduce the activities of the manager as much as possible. The second question about the price. This price is not now. This price is estimated with the growth of the client base and not on the banking system of Russian Federation and not only in the banking system. Although clients are ready to buy products for this price even in Russia, on our opinion, it's not a very big sum. The question number one. How this product is distinguished from the solutions existing in the market, or I maybe just didn't get the functionality to the end, and to what extent is the product integrated to create the dashboard? Should it collect information from other systems responsible for information security, and how is this integration developed? First, on competitors. I can tell you that there are solutions of such class. They are more oriented on the technical part, on the collection of logs, on the detection of some abnormalities in these logs. But we concentrate and we plan to concentrate still on management and analytics issues and on what is needed for the decision making. I don't say that there are no solutions like this. In Russia, there are a couple of players in this market, but the market is not still divided. It's still not divided. There are big vendors globally, but even Gartner starts to split this segment because there are very many different solutions. But we focus on the on management and information security. Yes, you're right, the integration would be needed. And currently, we started to integrate ourselves with CM solutions. I wouldn't say it's a long year integration. We're just in the beginning of the journey. But in terms of automation, which is needed, we, of course, will need integration. And now we are in the process of negotiations with some companies to strengthen this integration going forward. Thank you very much for your talk and for your questions, for your answers. I'd like to invite Artur with SODA program. My name is Artur, Koda company. I'll tell you about the new ways how to combat maleficent programs. It's around 100 million events of malicious programs for the last years. The program comes to the virus analytics. The analyst analyzes it, issues a couple of signatures, updates the basis, and the malicious program is blocked. But from the time of its emergence until blocking this program, can do anything and can steal personal data and may do harm to the economics. So the technology of protection are lagging behind the attack technologies. What do we propose? We believe that it's time not to answer the question what is a malware, but what is a legitimate program, how a normal, healthy program should behave, and how to find abnormalities in its activities. And these abnormal activities are going to be considered as a potential threat. Such algorithms already exist, but unfortunately, they have a high number of false blockings. We developed the following structure. This is a client PO, which should be installed on a protected PC and which records the behavior of all programs. This is an expert. This is a server collecting all data from agents and carries out the analysis, and a consultant or advisor. This is a server which collects data from all protected networks. Who are our competitors? Competitors are proactive antiviruses and heap systems. What is our distinctive feature? We provide a system which can be adopted to protect a specific system with a specific installed program. We don't need any signature database. We can work in autonomous mode. Besides that, our system can detect abnormalities and not malware. For this program, we don't have any old or new malware. They all can be detected at once. Besides that, the protection for each system is unique, for each network is unique. Even if one network can be compromised, other networks can still be safe. So we can secure ourselves from massive epidemies. We have a strong team, a strong scientific team. Baklanovsky Maxim is working for more than 15 years in the security area. Cherikhov, professor, holder of software engineering. We are supporting by PhD of economics, Mr. Turkot. And I am a specialist in the programming system. The world information security market is huge, and it is working rapidly, especially in Russia. What is our business model? We plan to sell it both to business, and we have also an intent agreement with one major state-owned company, and we will provide software free of charge and provide paid subscriptions for servers. The current state is we have a proof of concept with realized our algorithms of software analysis. We have developed system architecture, and we need funds for annual development of a prototype. In a year from the development, we plan to start sales, and in 2 years, we plan to have 100,000 users. That was all. I'm ready to answer your questions. Dear colleagues, have you looked at your competitors? Farai, McAfee, do you know something about it? Yes, I looked at HEAPS, Safe and Sec, and Defense Wall. Okay, then, and sandboxes. Did you look at sandbox? It's not in 2 years when you start to do something, the market will be distributed. That's even worse case. Your technological development does not match the task in a direct sense of the world. What you're going to do, it's not possible to do by these means. If you want, for instance, to download all samples in your nice system, it would just go down. If you don't have a pre-filtering, if you don't use signature bases, you won't have a pre-filtering on computer. If you don't have reputation base, you don't have pre-filtering on reputation. And so you have no good means. I would explain it to you offline. Okay. We can provide tests. Simple question. You offer your system as an alternative to the existing antiviruses, as an alternative to their parts in terms of proactive defense from the malwares. Again, if you still have the same system, what would be the requirements to the performance, and won't you ruin the normal work, because why antivirus systems solve problems with signature methods and all methods? If you solve the problem only by one method, you get in the trap. So all malwares would be caught in one time, and normal, but hackers would write a program which would pretend that it's a normal program, and you would pass it, but signature method wouldn't pass it. The current monitor versions hold the system by 10-15%, and we're going to improve this indicator. Okay, if, for instance, a malware is in a controlled environment, you make a static. Do you make a static analysis? For instance, if a deferred start of malware code for 2 weeks, how can you detect it? Then we're going to detect it at the point of start in 2 weeks when it's spread out into your organization. We do only behavioral analysis. So you have lots of work to be done.
If there's no more questions, thank you, Arthur, for your presentation. Questions were very interesting regarding the project. And now I'd like to invite next team, traffic team, with their project of monitoring. And now microphone, please. Good morning. I'm Ruslanov Valery, Ruslanov Traffic. I manage the product. I'd like to say a few words about this new direction in which we work, DevOps system with big data system. At this point, our company is in the analysis of the network traffic. We have large experience in this field. We have a very powerful engine of content analysis. Now we started two new directions, big data and system integration. Regarding well, the area where we are moving now, the DLP system, high enterprise and enterprise of the company level. Correspondingly, in these companies, they have specific problems which are due to the complexity of architecture, of the network architecture with a large amount of data, and typically what is required is a good scalability of the project. At this, Gartner now approaches the DLP system about $830 million, which will reach by 2014, and we have a large number of competitors, both on the Russian market and on the world market as well. What our system is now? It's a box system. We have already the number of users in big companies, 6,000 users. Our system can protect the full perimeter of the network and has a high throughput capability. Also, I would like to note that our system is easily managed, and what we see in this segment made us with a friendly interface, and correspondingly, I say we differ positively from competitors in that. Well, we look at what the best they have, we enhance that, and on the Russian market, we have a lot of plus in our favor that we support Russian language versions, unlike Western competitors, and we work very well with our service Mail.ru, Yandex, Rumble, and so on. So, and correspondingly in contact and so on and other users. So can we get back the presentation? So, well, big data, what we need it for? Big data makes it possible for us to work with large amount of data, and we'd like to improve significantly with big companies. Usually there's volume of data which needed to be gathered, analyzed with the security. So it amounts to up to petabytes data over 1 year. That kind of data is a problem where it should be stored and how to report them. We want with the new technologies to address this problem in one fell swoop. And in addition, we we get some additional benefits as analysis of animal behavior of the user and go to proactive things like blocking the systems, the machine that starts to behave in anomalous way. So what investors are looking for? In order to start up this project, we need to just accumulate about six top-class specialists to our team. We expect that our costs will be in the tune of $1.2 million per 1 year and 2 months. And with the average in high enterprise from $230 to $3 million, the payback period will be minimum. Well, our standard purchases are banks and insurance companies and government companies. And now, evidently, my time is up. Thank you very much about the presentation of the project. Well, frankly speaking, what is the essence? Where is the meat, so to say? Well, Dolpy project products, I think you are familiar with. Well, typically, a lot of people are in analysis, and what comes to the outside, analyze what the user mailed. But for big companies, there's a big problem, as I mentioned. The volume of data which we need to analyze, we found that about half a year we had a potential leak. Now we want to build a report for that period, see what is suspicious there, just to dig to the bottom, just what was sent from the company over 1 year period, and that presents a rather big problem. Is it really so? Well, from our point, yes, this is a big problem. I think in this audience, there's two people at least that can take exception to what you say. Well, I don't understand about big data. You about to analyze technical parameters, the gathering of technical parameters for all the edges and to add to content analysis to that. Is that saying, well, by and large, yes, we'll analyze content and what is written on the outside devices and what is sent to the network. This is a standard approach. But what you want to develop for it, you want to analyze also parameters of the printers. We're already doing that, and we plan. But at this point in time, we focus on the volume which we can just fit into the standard database. But can you advise me what is the technical innovation thing here? At this point of time, I don't visualize a system that can work at the juncture of the system and data. So this will make it possible to store much more data. And I'm not clear about big data, but let it. Well, could you also throw more light on? No, I forgot what I was about. Yes. So. Well, could you tell us, the competitive edge, technological competitive edge, you said other people cannot just process big data, and you claim that you can. Well, how you can do that? Well, we at this point in time, we can process them, but we cannot store them completely, 100%. But what do you need it for to store? Oftentimes, one of the most important goals is to store all data that went out of the company, then analyze where the leak happened. Well, that term, linguistic stenography, I'm familiar with. Steganography, linguistic stenography. From company, anything can leak out from a game, whatever. And never, not through content analysis, you'll find it. I cannot agree more with that. Well, thank you for your questions. Thank you for the presenter, for the presenting his project. And now I'd like to invite to this podium the next program, Bakurt program. The corporate face recognition based on the 3D machine vision technology. Well, is it, how we can do that bet? Well, I'm Alexei Kadishvili, technical director of Accord company. I would like to say a few words about one of the projects of this kind, system of the 3D identification of the person. Well, in order to save time, I just give in words my presentation, and on the screen, I'll just show you the clip that how the system operates. Probably this will be most understandable way of getting across what we want to tell. Well, while they're just starting, so the subject matter we deal with in this project, the system of biometric systems. Well, at this point in time, biometrics used in such goals where you need identification or auto-identification is that we have to confirm the personal appearance. The person just give his passport, we should authenticate that they should, or person wants to get the remote access to themselves, we have to confirm that he is indeed the person who he wants to get the access to some premises, we have to make sure that he is the right person to get into the facility. The task of identification is about what we to have a person. We can look a criminal in the crowd, or we can look for a purchaser in the shopping mall. So, correspondingly, at this point in time, the major biometric technologies is the recognition using the fingerprints, the using the retina and face. Well, fingerprints, this technology is most widespread presently, it's very well known, it's cheap, it's accurate. Well, it's you have to touch something, and this is its disadvantages. Because of that, this technology is rather slow because you need to interact with the gadget. The next technology is identification using retina. In that case, again, this good accuracy technology is very fast, but it's very costly. The third technology is recognition, face recognition through photographs. This technology is cheap, fast, good to use, could use both on corporate, non-corporate mode. Person might not know that you want to, but this is not an agreement. Whatever people just deviates more than 50 degrees from the camera from which we are monitoring, any automatic recognition stops. The technology that we work on, technology that to overcome that shortcomings, we make the 3D model of the face of the person, then we use this model for recognition. Our main achievement here that we learned how to do this 3D model just the person goes through the certain distance of in 2-3 seconds we create two 3D model and can compare to the database for the wanted list. So this technology have good advantages compared to this 3D recognition, which is about that we have information not about the form but also the texture of the face. We not only to compare 3D image, also 3D of the person that we compared with the usual photograph that we could have if we are talking about some well of the we're looking for some criminals. The accuracy is much better than we compare 2D to 2D. The computer platform is not very costly, is as a usual PC with a graphic expediter. The market to which we target is about $13 billion in 13 years. The market grows by 13% to 20. It will be that growth rate. Our technology is rather unique because the existing alternative 3D recognition technology, they are built on the structural just lighting, and they have certain limitation. Very thank you for your presentation. Now the time for questions from the panel. Well, indeed, you are speaking because nothing happened before your this 3D models. starting from Sapphire Vision that happened about 13 years ago and ending with Apple. This is just commonplace. What is your advantages? So if we compare to Alpha Vision and what happened after that, all this, so we can connect also. Well, the main problem is as the sun goes out, so it stops working. All information they have is about the form of the surface. There's no texture content. So if the person is not in the base, you cannot identify him. Is basing in which way our system differs. You're talking about the user difference. I'm taking of the essence. Well, where it has been published, published what? Your algorithm, our algorithm, staking is our commercial know-how. Of course, we will not publish algorithm, but we have a number of publications in the conferences where we reported about the results of our work. Well, more questions from the panel? If not, then thank you. Thank you for your presentation. Now, I'd like to invite the next participant, Chites Company, where this their project about the security buyer device, Chitak. Good morning. My name is Islam. I represent Chitech Company, and that is in the business of developments in the automation systems and other smart systems. Now, let me say a few words about the gadget that is the system for protection, technical system of information protection, USB carrier of information, which has technical protection. For instance, today there's certain information protection on USB carriers. There's involving fingerprints, involving other systems. Our system differs in that, for instance, if you, for instance, you lost your information carrier, that the other people couldn't have access to that information. This is done through the use of the transmitting device. So if you go away from your gadget, for instance, the access to that gadget, to that information, other people cannot get to. Well, by and large, this is the problem we are working on. Who needs that? This is all these people who store some very important information on such carriers. Well, these are typical users, ordinary users who will just wouldn't like to share the information with other people. The systems that exist today, this hardware protection of information, it turned out that not all systems can be trusted. Well, our system differs from those systems. Here we speak about the market, about all the information carriers that were sold, and the forecast for year 16. Well, presently, a prototype has been created of this system. Well, it's not clearly visible here, though there's transmitting the devices, there's the system of information itself. The team includes myself as the general director of this company. There's also Mansour, he economist, and there's several people who are in the development business. Well, they are. This is our experience, and indeed we are looking for investments. For the start, we need 2 million to get it off the ground. This money is needed in order to create the minimum viable product and to go on developing it further. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. Now your questions, please. Well, how your technology works? So it works in the following manner. There's the carrier information, and there's some transmitting device. like a keychain, for instance. For instance, if you go away from your carrier of information, then the access to information is blocked. So if I lost this keychain, then you need to get in touch with your how decoding is, why you are unhappy with with the encryption. Encryption is a good method, but in that case, we go different path. This hardware, not software, but hardware protection we opted for. But I didn't understand. Could you tell us, please, information on the carrier, is it encrypted? No, information on the carrier is not encrypted. Then, what is the problem? You can carry the carrier, get the carrier, and get the information. Well, we close the access, so we. How you do that? We do it through using this the hardware blocking of this information. Well. Actually, once you go away from that gadget, this so the information is not encrypted, and you get off this blocking and you get it. So this is how it works. Well, the thing is, we plan to produce the carrier so that you couldn't get into this carrier using other gadget. Well, regarding business model, my question, you gave the data about USB drives, and you mentioned there that 275 in 3 years, there will be 300. Why there will be 300? But I think it will be much less. But this is not our data. It's analysts gave us this information. But let's think about it. Why for the modem USB flash? Why the? Well, indeed. Well, whether well, let's ask those who should raise the hands who have USB flash. So, 50%. In 3 years, it will be much less than that. Indeed, this is indeed so. So, more questions? No?
And the next project that they wanted to present is the project which was developed by the Russian Encryption Center. Please, you have the floor. Quantum cryptography. Good morning. My name is Alexei Fedorov, and I'd like to tell you about the quantum cryptography, the project which is being under development in the Russian Cryptographic Center. All the talks about security that we lead, they are quite different in terms of algorithmic level or mathematical level, or if we speak about them, some fundamental security guaranteed by nature. Today we use all systems with open key cryptography, which is safe in case of computation resources. The quantum computer can break all systems with open key. So what we think about? We think about moving the problem of information security from mathematics and algorithms to physics. To provide information security on the natural law level. How can it be done? It can be done by distributing the key to optical systems, because the by single photons, we can guarantee that the information is intercepted. We can know about it. It's to the fact that photon cannot be copied. It cannot be split. It's a quant. It's one particle. And it's not possible to measure it without breaking the quant state. What's we going to be done? We are going to do several projects, two sub-projects basically. First, developing of the prototype of cryptography based on communication lines, on fiber optic, and quantum cryptography in a free space. Our experience allows us to develop such systems because our team has competences both in fundamental sciences of quantum optics, and we had lots of tests with single photons and their detection, and we have some commercial experience. We're interested in investments because quantum technology is a good area which should not be neglected in terms of investment, because the quantum limit is a very promising technology, and we'd like to propose two systems. The first systems of key distribution by cables, which would be interesting to banks and all commercial organizations and organizations which are willing to protect their information, and the system of key distribution in the open space, including satellite systems, which could be interesting to defense industry or to state-owned institutions. So what is the main idea? We would like to extend the length of the cable, the communication channel we want to use for the key distribution. It is possible due to a number of technologies. We propose new repeaters, new for quantum photons, new distribution protocols. We propose new sources, and we propose new detectors. So basically, we will in all areas of the channel, repeater, transmitter. We have solutions for all areas. And now we are focusing on building the quantum distribution system up to 250 kilometers. We have some experience here in our team. There are people who did the first installation of quantum cryptography in Russia. We're interested in cooperation with those who are engaged in quantum cryptography creation in the open space. This is a Novosibirsk Scientific Institute. And what is our focus of now is a quantum repeaters systems to increase lengths of key distribution. Thank you very much for your project presentation. Please, your questions. Quantum cryptography, you mean the transmission of one photon? More exactly, not quantum cryptography, but quantum key distribution. This is a system where a key is formed by transmitting a message by single photons. Alice and Bob, they exchange photons in their algorithm after some processing, which allow to get information and to exchange the secret key, which can be used as one-time pad. With the state, the photon will be in the superposition state. After we measure it, it's going to be polarized. We measure this polarization, and we get 0 or 1. And it is the description is in protocols. And how do you estimate the result of the previous year with 300 kilometers without repeater by Astrium? It's a wonderful result. And how do you evaluate it? You say 250 with repeaters, and here we have 300 without repeaters with atmosphere, but we speak about cables. But they did it in the atmosphere. Well, they're good guys. Well, what would be your evaluation? I would provide two things. Who did this? You know. Yes, of course. From which country is this group? It's a European one. So we in Russia can use Western technologies to provide information security, but that's would be wrong in terms of paradigm. All security protection means should be developed in the country where they're going to be used. But in terms of technique, my pure technical question, how do you evaluate the result versus yours? This result is better than ours. Thank you. You know, you didn't show us a detailed business model. Well, you're right. What would be more interesting for me? We're interested in investment, the amount of investments that we are interested for all three projects they are presented here. The business model is basically to create a box, a device to to distribute the key between two points, between Alice and Bob. There is a market. We evaluated the market, and basically, maybe this is the last phrase would give you partially the answer. Just 4 minutes for the fundamental technology, it's not enough. For me, as a fraudster, would be interesting to have your repeaters. That's the main problem. Yeah, you're right. When it is without repeaters, then it's cool. But with repeaters, there are some risks. There's an opportunity. So the main problem, as far as I understand you correctly, each repeater, it's like a fraudster, right? It's a compromising. If you compromise the repeater, so you're fine. From the fundamental point of view, it's possible to do a repeater when you know how to do it. Your can be done and broken. But how? So you show us, and we will explain how to break it, okay? Thank you, dear colleagues. Thank you for your questions. We're a little out of time. And now I would like to invite to the stage the next project, which is going to be the last one in our today's pitch session on information security. This is NATSIS Lab with the project Tempresto. Please, you have the floor. My name is Krasunovsky Alexander. I'm the general director of NATSIS Laboratory. We do Tempesta to have protection from DDoS attack. DDoS attack, this is sending of big amount of requests to the server. The server is overloaded and it's not able to process user requests. This is a very serious thing. It can compromise and can break down even a big segment of the internet. These are data on the DDoS protection market, prevention market. We cover a little bit web free wall market, and Tempesto provides also a useful solution there. The market basically is divided by very powerful players, so we use a little bit different strategy, which was used by MySQL once. So we open the sources and we distribute the basic version of the product, and we earn money for the paid module of support and customization. There is a special type of application-level DDoS. It's being now mentioned very often on professional conferences on DDoS security. These attacks are focused on the weakest points of your infrastructure, of your website, and they break it efficiently. These attacks can be detected very, very complicated. The main thing is to filter user requests with a concrete IP address and some content of this request. It can be done at the level of applied HTTP servers, but it's very slow. Using firewalls, it's not possible because they work on a lower level. The correct solution would be here to use deep packet inspection. And big players use this approach. But there's no open source, and these solutions are quite expensive. And let's look, what do we have more? Nobody interests where there's a DDoS or not on the site. Everybody's interested in a quick and proper work of the website. The solution of this task without DDoS workshop can be used by normal networks of data transmission, and normal servers are used there for content caching. If we combine both problems, we would need to build a filtering network and a caching network. Applied HTTP servers will be used there in combination with firewalls and filtration solutions. And here we have a problem. We are looking at additional communication between software, excessive functionality, and the solution is not as quick as needed to combat extreme loads during DDoS. The idea of the project is to use powerful and very specific technologies to solve the productivity problems, both in DDoS and without it. We use some novelties, and they are enlisted there. I can tell in more detail about them if you wish, if we compare our approach to other approaches. Tempest is the only one and the first one hybrid of firewall and HTTP accelerator, and as against low-level solutions, it provides improved productability, efficiency, and all necessary functionality, and at low price. We have an international team. All developers are very high skilled. Now we are helping our customer to make a very fast web application firewall. We've been working in the market 6 years already, and we have our product on HTTPI, which filters the real traffic. This is a list of our clients. I'd like to know that all of them have their own powerful development departments, but they still use our consulting. I'm looking for clients and partners. We're not looking for money. The main areas of our work are telecommunications, data networks, filtering networks, and big web resources. Thank you. Please, your questions, dear jury. What about the payback? We're not on a break-even point. No, we provide consulting and make services on demand. We have own DPI product, which starts to be paid back, but DPS is done on from our funds. Among competitors, there were no Redware. Have you looked at them? Yes, I looked at the Redware, but I told you initially there are many competitors and the market is strongly divided. So we're nobody. We cannot make our box and offer it to everyone. We should go from the bottom. So you indicated Beeline. They implemented Redware recently. This is the story of 2008, 9. And we did a DPI system for statistics for them. And Akamai, they have 30% of global traffic. How can you compete with them? Kamei is what we are going to achieve. This is ICDN and traffic filtration both, because in Russia we have the traffic filtration system. They don't provide acceleration. We don't do our service of network. We provide such solution for people who build up caching networks for big companies, which can do a filtration solutions and acceleration solutions. We won't be competing with Akamai and other big networks. How do you see your customer? Who is going to buy from you? A big company which has its server farm? Companies who want to have solutions for traffic filtration, who use Arbo, Cisco solutions, and basically that's all. And why should they be unhappy with Arbo, Cisco? Why should they buy you? Well, if you look at what Rostelecom does, if you look at the presentation of 2012 at Acharod, they have hardware on Arbor. The hardware filters low-level network traffic, and the applicable logic was done in-house. And the main processing point is suitable for our analyzers, for our products. And the second thing, Arbor. About Arbor is not independent hardware, it's a BVM. We worked with BVM, and that's a complicated thing. It is very expensive, and we're able to deliver a product on a simple Intel platform with the productivity high above MBVO, and we can communicate with Arbor and other vendors to use our technology. Dear colleagues, maybe the last question. Now, the DDoS protection servers, if you know High Load Lab and Kaspersky, the second player. So do you evaluate them more as competitors or as possible technological partners? With Alexander Milyavin, I communicated at Fileover, and we discussed their solutions. They have DPI, Nginx type, and our solution is more interesting because DPI, it has to process HTTP traffic twice or should provide the traffic exchange. We embedded our system in HP stack, and we can process about 1 million cores. They could be both partners and clients of ours. Thank you very much for your presentation. I would organize, would ask the organizers to set the next slide and the clicker, please.
So now we're downloading the next presentation, but while we do this, a few words about our program for today. So, well, presently, members of our panel will just sum up. We will select one of the winners. On that transparency, let me introduce the members of our panel, which is panel of judges: Pavel Bogdanov, partner of Almaz Capital; Ruslan Bondarev, head of the Sberbank Technology; Sergey Velch, head of the division of digital business; Sberbank Technology, Anna Vishlov, regional Semantic; Sergey Gardechik, deputy general director of Positive Technology; Sergey Garshkov, head of the division for technological studies; Sberbank Technology, Sergey Dmitriev, head general director of the IBM Center; Sergey Yeremin, managing partner of Microsoft Software; Kasperskaya InfraWorks; Mikhail Konrads, merited engineer, Cisco; Alexander Kulishov, director from the Institute of the Data Transfer Information; Anna Nakhova, investment director from Lab Capital; Sergey Toprov, investment management letter group; Igor Kamel, or rather, managing director of the Department for Development of the Digital Business Sberbank Technology; Dmitry Dmitry Shakhatarov, director for Department of Sberbank Technology; Pavel Egis, general director of the Russian representative McAfee in Russian CIS. Now we're just members of the panel evaluated 12 projects that we just now listened to. Within this pitch session, we also will be Google Glass a special prize for the winner. One of the companies will be awarded that prize. And also, today is the first day when any company which is implementing the information security project can file application for iSecurity. Today, the first day for the this application, and you can file this application till the September 30th. Thank you for your participation. Thank you, the panel, for your work. Now, I Now we just take all the forms, just sum up, and then we just prepare the minutes. Now I invite the next team to take seats in that hall. So now the colleague will collect all evaluation forms, which will just assess and pronounce our verdict later on.